Hello, creators! In today's video, we'll take an in-depth look at the new segmentation effect introduced in VSDC version 9.2. We will explore its capabilities and show you how you can effectively utilize it in your projects. Let's dive right in! This effect is perfect for scenarios where you need to isolate an object from the background, allowing you to apply color correction and blurring. Additionally, you can overlay masks, extract the object entirely from the video, and even add outlines to highlight your selection. It's versatile enough to handle both photo and video materials seamlessly. Segmentation can be found under Video Effects, Special Effects, Segmentation. Like all effects, it will be added inside the selected object in the timeline. To proceed, you'll need to load segmentation models. In the Properties window, click Download Data Model, download an AI model from the website, and import it into the program using the Import Data Model option. There are four models available. FBSAM and SAMHQ are more precise but resource-intensive, while Edge SAM and Mobile SAM are simpler and less demanding. For this tutorial, we will use Mobile SAM. After importing into the program, the next step is to create the first region. A region is an area designated for analysis, where the algorithm will search for the object to be cut out. Click Add Region and select the Include Region option. The results of the segmentation will immediately appear in the selected area in the preview window as a black and white mask. Now, let's move on to the properties. The first important parameter is processing mode, which determines whether the tool will use the resources of the graphics card, hardware, or the computer's own resources, software, for segmentation. The next parameter, output, has two settings. The first is a black and white mask mode, and the second is composite, which displays the cutout object in its original form. The contour style property determines how the contour of the selected object is displayed. If composite mode is selected, three contour styles are available, displaying only the contour of the cutout object and displaying the contour of the cutout object over the original image. All contour styles offer nearly identical settings, allowing you to change the composition mode, color, transparency, and thickness of the contour, and also provide a fill option. The Contours for Regions parameter enables a separate setting for the contour thickness of all regions you add. Setting Display All Contours to False retains only the outline of the largest contour, removing smaller ones. The last general setting for segmentation is Post Filtering, which helps to smooth the edges of the cutout object with four types of filters available. The Median filter gently smoothes the edges, while the Min-Max filter either expands or reduces the boundary of the object. The last two, Blur filter and Contour Blur Level, are responsible for blurring the boundary. Let's move on to the region settings. The first property controls the color of the marker in the middle of the region area, which is useful for identification, useful when multiple regions are created. In this section, you can also disable a region or apply post-filtering to the current region. The coordinate type property lets you adjust the region size or analyze the entire image. With relative coordinates, you can set key points for animation, fully controlling the analysis area and removing unwanted elements. For frame-by-frame editing errors, refine the algorithm with two specific tools. The first tool allows you to add additional regions, either included or excluded. This can be done by clicking again on the Add Region option or by changing the mode of an already created region. Excluded regions have the same settings and can also be animated. The number of regions you can create in the program is unlimited. The second method involves adding a refinement point, which can either expand, include point, or reduce, exclude point, the analysis area of the algorithm. The position of this point can be animated, providing precise control over how the area is analyzed throughout your video. If you need a refinement point to only appear for a few frames and track a specific area, set it to tracking point mode in the coordinate type field. First, create it using the Add Tracking Point option from the left scene menu, adjust its position and duration, then link it to the segmentation point. For animation, use the Movement tool for motion vectors or the Motion Tracking function to create a map that tracks object movements. Temporarily disable the segmentation effect, right-click on the video, select Create Movement Map. Specify an area that is clearly visible throughout the video and start the analysis. As a result, a movement path for the object will be created, and you can apply it to the tracking point via Add Object, Movement, Movement Map. Now, re-enable the segmentation effect, and your segmentation refinement point will move along the previously created trajectory. The number of points, like regions, is unlimited. View results in the preview window, and for low-performance PCs, consider exporting the project for smoother previewing. If you're not satisfied with the outcome, you can also change the segmentation model, but it's better to do this in the early stages, as they operate differently and require specific types of points and regions. That is all for now. You've done great work. If you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comments. We'll leave a written guide for the segmentation tool in the pinned comment. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.